CBS presents this program in color.
You can win this beautiful car with just one answer on Car Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Car Shark, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you, Gene. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Car Shark. We're having a great time this week. I want you to take a look at this. Take a look at this now. This is an F-14 Tomcat whose top speed is over 1,400 miles per hour. Now, it's approaching the aircraft carrier USS Nimitz, and the pilot will have to land that plane on only 400 feet of runway on a pitching, rolling flight deck, coming to a stop in less than 2 seconds. Isn't that amazing? Well, the men responsible for flying those jets are graduates of the Navy Fighter Weapons School, better known to us as Top Guns. We've got 10 of them with us in our studio audience all this week. We'll meet them a little later on, but right now let's say hi to our two lovely dealers on Card Shark. Our two Top Guns are Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Here they are.
How are you?
I'm just fine.
Good.
Talk about countdown.
Yes.
Lacey's getting close. So yeah. Deal out the cards very carefully. Would you do that for me? And we'll get our card sharks in here right now. Clara and Martin, please come in here. How are you, kid?
Fine.
Good. It's nice to have you back with us.
Thank you. You know,
nice this lady is 83 years old. She's our champion. She's won $4,500.
Oh,
nice. You didn't know that, did you? Yeah, you knew it, didn't you? But in your earlier life, when you worked, what did you do?
We had a bakery shop for 25 years.
For about?
In East Los Angeles.
In the Los Angeles area?
East Los Angeles.
How long have you been in Southern California?
50 years.
50 years. Well, it's nice to have you back with us, Clara.
I came here in 1938.
That's the year I was born.
1938?
Yeah.
You're just halfway.
Halfway to what?
Halfway.
I feel like I'm more than halfway, huh? Martin, welcome back.
Thank you. My name's Martin. I am married. It's been about 3 years. I have a baby boy that's 1 year old, and we're expecting another one in February.
Oh, that's great. Well, it's nice to have you back with us. If
Thank
you recall,
you. It's good to be
we're
back.
The player who wins two games, it's our champion, and Clara won the first game. So, Martin, you have to win this game. When we left last time, I was ready to ask the second question in game number two.
Okay.
That's what I'll do right now, then, Clara. And that question belongs to you.
Okay.
And this question involves our 10 men who are Top Guns in our studio audience. There they are. Gentlemen, welcome back. Nice to have you back with us. Now, Claire, before the show, we ask our 10 Top Guns, while piloting your jet, have you ever tried such a tricky maneuver that you actually lost control? How many of these 10 Top Guns have tried such a tricky maneuver that they actually lost control?
I don't think they would be that foolish. It's difficult enough.
You think that would be foolish to do that?
Yeah, right. Yeah. It would be foolish to do that. I don't think too many. I think maybe about four.
There's four fools down there. Is that what you're telling me?
No. I said just foolish to do
that. I see. Martin will be higher or lower than that?
I think it's going to be lower.
It might be lower than that? Well, the actual number of these Top Guns who have tried such a tricky maneuver they lost control is 9 of them. Wow. Which 9 of you guys have done that? Raise your hand if you would, please. Oh, look at everybody but the animal raised his hand. Figured. Barney, you raise your hand at everything, don't you? You must be the bad boy of the group.
No, sir, Bob. Sorry about the sir. Actually, we don't go out, Bob, and just fly the airplane to do tricks, but we're always trying to expand the aerodynamics or how we can feel flying the airplane. And occasionally it will depart what would be normal flight. And for myself, we were out flying one afternoon, very high. Both engines quit on the airplane at around 47,000 feet, and was around 10,000 feet before we got them lit again.
No kidding. Who's we?
The other pilot in the airplane.
Oh, he's not with us today?
No.
Pardon me? He's not with us. He's not among your top 10 group. He doesn't want
not
to go
anymore.
With you anywhere, does he, Barney? Okay, thank you, gentlemen, very much. Nice to have you here. 7, Claire, want to change it? Okay, here we go. The 7 now is a 9, Clara.
Lower
than the 9, the lady says. No, it's not lower than the 9. Martin has some serious catching up to do. Let's see if he can do it right now. Martin,
we're going
to
go higher than a 3.
Higher than a 3, 7 is yours.
We're going to go higher than that 7,
Higher than
Bob.
The 7, 6, no. So we go back to the base card. We'll pause for these words, and we'll be right back with more Card Judge right after this.
Couple you'll love.
Hello, couples.
Bob Eubanks and Gary Kroger.
Welcome to the Newlywed Game.
Because newlywed variety is the spice of life.
Is that right?
The Newlywed Game with Bob and or Gary. Tonight, starting at 9 on Buzzer. Let's play.
Sorry, so now we're going to continue. Martin, the next question belongs to you. And this is an educated guess question, Martin. 26% of all the people in the United States are considered overweight. What percentage of all the dogs in the United States are overweight?
Oh, that is an educational question.
These are the kind of things that you don't find on Jeopardy, you know what I mean?
These at least I can come close, I believe. I think 30%.
30% of the dogs are overweight.
Correct.
In the United States. Clara?
I don't think so. I think it's lower.
Think it's lower than that?
Yes.
Actual percentage of American dogs that are overweight is 40%. 40% of American dogs are overweight. That means that Martin's got the control. Your dog overweight?
No, she's really skinny.
Good. Glad to hear that. Okay.
Martin, go you higher ready? Higher than a three.
Higher than a three. Queen.
Lower than a queen.
Lower. Yeah.
We're going to go higher than a seven.
Higher than the seven. Yeah.
Lower than the ace.
All right. In order to tie it up, is it lower than the ace? It
yeah.
certainly is.
That was a chance.
Okay. That was a chance, man. I was going to teach you a new word called freeze, but you did just fine. It's okay. So we're going to set up now for our tiebreaker because each contestant has won a game, and that means that the winner of the next game is our champion, all right? So let's get it going right now. Three cards will be dealt out. It's a one-question sudden-death game, and the question goes to you, Claire. Surveyed 100 unmarried men over the age of 65. Hey, we've hit your target right now, kiddo. We ask them, since you've turned 65, has a woman slapped you for getting fresh? How many senior citizen men said a woman has slapped them for getting fresh?
Out of 100?
Yeah.
How many?
Same question I ask you, hon.
Well,
you ever slapped a guy for getting fresh?
No.
No.
No. My guys were nice guys.
I'm sorry.
No, I would think that would be about 30.
30 senior citizen men said a woman has slapped them for getting fresh. Martin, what do you think?
I think that's going to be a little bit lower, even though I'm sure it has happened.
Well, let's see. Actual number of senior citizen men who said a woman has slapped them for getting fresh is 3 of them. Yeah, only 3 of them. Okay, Martin, right. Now. I'll show you your base card, Martin, and I'll show you Clara's. Keep in mind, you can change yours if you want to. The 8 is yours. Clara gets a 4. Martin, you can change the 8. And play it out. If you goof, she's the champ, or pass it on to Clara with the 4. If she makes a mistake, you are the champ.
I'm going to go ahead and change that card and play it
change
myself.
It and play it, all right? Mm-hmm. Take your fate in your own hands. The 8 becomes an 8 again. Oh. Now the pressure's on.
The higher one stuck with me before. Let's try it again.
You're going higher, you say?
That's correct.
Higher than the 8? No! Clara, you're the champ again!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you. Giant killer. Hey, Mark! 100 dollars for you. I didn't know if you get that.
Great.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
It was a pleasure.
Clara.
You devil, you just beat the Marines that time.
I'll tell you what, you're something else, isn't it? Now, you know what happened last time you did this? You won over $4,000, so
you know
all the rules.
Yeah, right.
Okay, well, the girls are about to get in here and deal out the cards, but we're going to pause for these words, and we'll be right back, and then she's going to try to win the money and a new card.
Okay.
Welcome back to Card Shark. Our 83 years young champion is ready to try it again. Isn't this fun?
A lot of fun.
I know, a lot of fun. You're overlooking those cards.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to give you some money to bet with.
Okay,
but remember, you can change one card per line. Keep that in mind.
Thank you.
Let's give her $200. She's got it. Come on, Clara. Here we go, hon.
Okay.
Now, Clara, we're going to start you off with this card. You got $200, and you've got a 9. You can play or change.
Change it.
Which one would you like, hon?
One.
Number one. Fine. Let's see what Lacey's got for you. The 9 becomes a queen, and you got 200. How much?
Oh, 100.
100 down. 100 lower than the queen. That's okay. Wasn't lower, but you still got $100. Now let's bet it again. Here we go.
All of it lower.
All of it lower than the king. There you are. $200, Clara. Can't change it.
$100 lower.
$100 lower than the eight. No. It's all right. It's okay. We're going to come up here. You still got $100 and give you another $400 up here. So it gives you a grand total of $500.
Change that card.
Going to change this card too. Which one?
Number two.
Win some money now. Come on, Claire. The 10 is a 9. Those are ugly cards, aren't they? You got $500, sweetie.
$100 lower.
$100 lower than the 9. There we go. $600.
$200 higher.
$200 higher than the 4. There we are again. $800, Claire, with the worst cards I've ever seen.
$100 lower.
$100 lower than the 7. Now on target. Okay. You can still win $1,800, you bet. It's going to be worth $1,800. Is it higher than the deuce? Of course it is. Sure. Okay.
Okay.
Made it a good situation after all, because now, you know what you've won? $6,400.
Oh, yeah.
And now we're going to try to win a new car. Well, let's see. You almost won a new car last time.
Yeah,
you came
within
one. Okay, we have a new way of playing for that new car, but before we tell you about that, Gene is going to tell us about the car that Clara can win. Come here, Clara.
The Buick Skyhawk Coupe, the sports car with room and comfort, equipped with standard features plus pinstripes and California emission. Good luck, Clara.
Thank you, Gino. Okay, Clara. Now, in order to win that car, I'm going to ask you a question about our 10 Top Guns right there in our studio audience. And then after I ask you that question, I want you to go over there and register your answer on the range board, all right? Lace, would you hand me a question, please? Thank you. Clara, remember, this is about our 10 Top Guns. Before the show, we ask our Top Guns, was your father also in the Navy? How many of these 10 Top Guns said their father was also in the Navy? I want you to go over there now and place the marker on your answer.
Three.
Boy, she's looking at him, isn't she?
Yeah, there's 10 of them. I'm going to leave it at 5.
Pardon me? I'm going to keep it right there at 5. You didn't even have to go over there, did you?
No. I'm going to leave it at 5.
We're going to leave it. Yeah, it saves time that way, too, and effort and energy. Well, let's see. Now, if the correct answer, if you hit it on the button, if it's 5, then you win the car. If you're 1 away, like if it's 4 or 6, then you win another $500 like you did last time. The actual number of these Top Guns, whose father was also in the Navy, is... 5 of them! Ladies, a winner, that's all. $15,815. Cash and prizes, including a new car. And we'll be back in just a moment with more card sharks.
Bye.
I got so excited she doesn't know what kind of car she won. You can pick the color. Yeah, you can pick out the color.
I didn't pick the color either yet. I'm thinking.
Oh, you're thinking about the color?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, it's okay. I'd get the limousine if it were me, I think. That's a nice car. It's yours.
Yeah.
Get your car out of here, will you, Claire?
I haven't got my license with me.
Oh, you don't have your license with you. Well, okay. It's time to meet a new challenger for you. Mark, come on in here and join us on Car Show.
Hi, Mark.
Hi, Clara.
Hi,
thank you.
Hi,
Bob.
Mark.
I'm great. Good. I'm Mark Vogel from Detroit, Michigan, and just a few short weeks ago, I became a newlywed. Just got married.
Oh, no kidding.
That's right. I married the prettiest girl in Houston, Texas.
You married the prettiest girl in Houston,
the
Texas.
The prettiest girl in Houston.
You had to leave Detroit to find one?
I took a lot of the country, but I found her.
Oh, that way.
That's
okay,
right.
Mark. Good. If you win two games, you're the champ. Let's get it going right now. Cards are being dealt out. And Clara, the first question is yours.
Okay.
You're so good at all these questions. I know you're ready.
I'm ready.
Boy, you are ready. We surveyed 100 married women. We asked them, is your wedding day the last time you saw your husband in a tuxedo? How many married women said their wedding day was the last time they saw their husband in a tuxedo?
I think that would be a low number a high number.
You just pick whichever one you want, Claire. It doesn't matter to me. You're usually right anyway. So.
Did they see them or did they not see them? That's the question.
Beats the heck out of me, babe. I just don't know. How many married women said their wedding day was the last time they saw their husband in a tuxedo?
I would say about 65.
65 out of 100. Let's see what Mark says.
Well, Bob, I'm a musician, and I'm in a tuxedo a lot. And I'm just married. My wife sees me in a tuxedo quite often. But that's not typical, I don't believe.
Are you a drummer, Mark?
No. I'm
sure our audio man thinks that you are.
Okay, no drumming. Anyway, so we're going with 65. I think the average American man doesn't wear a tux too often, so it might be a little bit lower.
A little bit. Now,
did I do that?
Yeah, I think we've done it backwards. How many married women said their wedding day was the last time they saw their husband in a tuxedo? She said 65.
Okay, then let's go a little bit higher.
I'm not trying to talk. Your reasoning didn't match your answer.
Thank you.
But then nobody's does. Clara's won a car and several $1,000s, and she hasn't said a word that I understand yet.
We got one stuff over there.
Clara, don't poison his mind. The actual number of married women who said their wedding day was the last time they saw their husband in a tuxedo is 45. Wasn't higher, it was lower. Okay, Clara. Clara's got the control, and the card's an 8, Clara.
Change that card.
Well, why not? Change that card. There we go. Queen.
Lower
than the queen, 4. Higher than the 4, 8.
Freeze.
Okay. Clara doesn't talk to me anymore. She just goes like this.
It's easier that way.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Mark, this is your question. This question involves our 10 men who are top guns in our studio audience, United States Navy. Before the show, we ask our 10 top guns, have you ever gotten airsick? How many of these 10 top guns admitted they have gotten airsick?
Airsick. Well, there's one thing about getting airsick, and there's something else to admitting it. And that's a pretty good-looking group of guys. I don't think too many of them would admit to getting airsick.
We're talking between beats again.
let's go for, maybe I'm destined to be a drummer. What do you think?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think so. How about, let's try 3 of them.
3 of the 10 you think have gotten airsick. Clara, what do you think about
this?
Well,
3 is a pretty low number, but I think it might be slightly higher.
3 is a pretty low number. Yep. Okay. You think it might be
slightly higher.
Actual number of these top guns who admitted they've gotten airsick is... 1. Only 1. Yeah, only 1. Who in the heck got airsick? Raise your hand. Hose, you got airsick.
That's right, Bob. I can't believe out of this group I'm the only guy that admitted that.
Most of them will blame it on the beer the night before, right?
Actually, that's not true. In course in F-14s, none of us get airsick, but when we start our training... long before we ever step into an F-14, it's pretty common to get airsick a couple times.
Don't they put you in the simulators and do all sure that rolling and all of that?
Sure they do.
And you're the only one on the entire group of guys that told the truth.
Bob, I'm an honest man.
He's a whip.
Yes. I can tell. With a name like that, you have to be honest. Yes. Okay. Mark. Here's the card, Mark. It is a 5.
5. Let's go higher.
Higher than the 5, Jack.
Lower.
Going lower. 7.
Freeze
right there, sure. Okay, so pretty good game going here. Let's try another question. Claire, I got one for you this time. You getting tired, hon?
No.
Oh, good. I didn't think so.
No, I'm not tired. Yeah. I can always drive home.
It's your car.
Yeah. Yeah.
We see a lot of high-speed car chases in the movies. So we surveyed 100 men, and we asked them, have you ever been in a high-speed car chase? How many men said they have?
No, that would be pretty low. That would be pretty low number. I would say about 24.
24 out of what?
Out of 100.
Oh, good. Okay. I'm learning. Mark would be higher or lower
than
24.
Well, I don't know. Action movies are pretty big out now, and that's pretty encouraging. And I used to have a sports car, and you'd pull up to a light, and the Porsche next to you would pull up to you, and it was pretty tempting. Whether that's high speed or not, I don't know. But let's go a little bit higher.
Okay. The actual number of men who have been in a high-speed car chase is... 32. Just a little bit higher, Mark. You're right.
All right.
Yes.
Change that 7.
Okay, change that 7. 7 will now be a 6, Mark.
Okay, let's go higher.
Higher than the 6. Deuce.
No.
Clara, you get a free chance. You can't change the card because he won't let you.
I can't change the card.
No, you didn't win the question.
I will go lower.
Lower, the lady says. It's lower than the 8, and it's not lower than the 8. No. Okay. So we'll play Sudden Death when we come back right after this. Don't go away.
Fresh Family Feud and Card Sharks military episodes. Buzzers salute to veterans. Continuing next.
Welcome back. That's all the time we have for today. We hope you'll join us next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye, everybody.
Some of our departing contestants will receive shampoo, conditioner, and gel, dermatologically certified for purity, sold exclusively at Fantastic Sam Salons. New Nabisco Frosted Wheat Squares. Crunchy, bite-sized, lightly frosted biscuits of shredded wheat for great nutrition, great taste. Fruit of the Loom underwear. Quality and value in pre-shrunk cotton underwear. Fruit of the Loom. We fit America. Sylvania Soft White Light Bulb. Guaranteed 5% longer life. Sylvania, where the best comes to life. Rental of the Rug Doctor for professional carpet and upholstery cleaning results at a fraction of the cost. Remember, there's only one Rug Doctor, steaming matted dirt. If you like a burger with the works, you love Manwich. It's the burger with the works inside. And a member of our studio audience will receive for quality performance the new Home 2022 versatile top loading machine. Has 22 stitches, buttonholer, and other features. The new Home Sewing Machine Company. This is Gene Woods speaking for Cut Shark. I'm Mark Goodson, television production.
Guaranteed to get you all fired up. It's Family Feud, then.
Yeah!
Play at home and catch a win on Card Sharks. Followed by The Price is Right.
A new car!
Weekdays on CBS, it's hot fun.